Hi guys, my name is Vani Duggal, aka The Spiritual She-Wolf. I am a personal development coach and a mental health therapist. Welcome back to my channel. So, in today's video, I am going to talk about how you can actually cheer yourself up when you're feeling down. Again, if you are feeling mentally ill, please find some helpline numbers down below so that you can seek help. And please seek help. You can check out these videos up here talking about how you can help yourself if you're depressed. I have a lot of tips in that video that would be really, really helpful for you. Getting out of a negative mindset is that one thing that only you can do. You know, like there could be a lot of people who would help you down the line, like your friends or your family or a counselor or a therapist or anyone else. They will really help you, but it's only you who can actually make it happen. Only you can get out of your negative mindset. Just so you know, I am also a mental health therapist. I am a personal development coach as well. So you can hit me up on Instagram if you want to talk to me about your issues. I am always here to help and I'm always here to listen to your issues. Now that that's out of the way, let's just get into this video and let's talk about that one thing that you need to do when you need to cheer yourself up. Let's go. In the psychology world, we actually called it coping mechanisms or coping skills or coping strategies. This can be good or bad. The thing is that I am labeling it as good or bad coping mechanisms because coping mechanisms itself is a very big umbrella term, okay? So, to the person who has substance abuse as a coping mechanism does not exactly see it as a bad thing until and unless it starts to harm them in a bad way. Okay, so I'm not exactly going to talk about coping mechanisms. I am going to talk about finding an outlet. So that's the one thing that you actually need to do. Have you ever felt like you're very angry and you want to take out your anger on something? You know, and you hit the gym. And as soon as you hit the gym, you do the weights, you sort of just take out all your anger on the weights, you have a great workout, and then you come back home and you feel amazing and stress-free as ever. Has that ever happened with you? Trust me, it has happened with me, but not in the gym scenario, but in a journaling scenario. Now, everybody has a different outlet to everything, okay? So it could be taking out your anger in the gym, it could be writing down in a journal, it could be just crying it out, or it could be, you know, doing some self-care activities. That's called an outlet, okay? So when things tend to get heavy on you or when you feel like life is going out of your control, you can always have this sort of an outlet to actually take out all of your emotions on that particular thing. Of course, it can also be a friend, it can be a therapist, it can be a family member. Anybody that you think would listen to your issues judgment-free. Always remember, guys, do not keep things inside of you and please get vocal about your issues. Don't just sit there and silently swallow down that hard feelings that you're having. Find an outlet, and I'll give you some examples of what sort of outlets you can actually find and what sort of outlets you can actually have which will make you feel a bit more happy in life. So the first kind of outlet you can have is a physical outlet. You can move your body. So I don't know if you've noticed these things or not. Whenever you feel negative, your body tends to get very heavy and very stiff. Okay, a lot of people think that dancing it out, doing yoga, having a small workout, you know, really, really helps them. So that is the first kind of an out, like that's the first thing that you can do is actually dance it out or, you know, move your body so that your body physically feels much better. The second kind of outlet you can have is sort of a mental check-in, you know. Becoming self-aware of your thoughts plays a very big role in all of these things. And once you start becoming aware of your thoughts, it gets a bit easier. Ask yourself why you're feeling what you're feeling, how can you make it better, what is that one thing that is making you feel this way? You know, all of these things. So mental check-ins are also another way of having an outlet. The third kind of an outlet you can have is get rid of clutter in your life. Now, it could be as easy as cleaning your room or cleaning your laptop or cleaning your phone, digital stuff, you know. It could be that sort of thing. But it could also be those things that actually make you feel a bit better about yourself. You know, so for example, if you follow somebody on social media and as soon as you come across their post, you don't feel that good about yourself. unfollow that person. That is also a sort of decluttering, you know. So it does not always have to be physical decluttering. It can also be digital or mental. So make sure you also get rid of clutter in your life whenever things get heavy on you. I think these are the basic outlets that you can have. A mental check-in, a physical check-in. Meditation also is a sort of an outlet. Personally speaking, for me, I journal a lot, okay? And I know that you guys know that. So I love journaling because journaling is a very safe place for me, you know? I love journaling my thoughts instead of, you know, talking about them. And it's not that I am silently, secretly swallowing all of those things. It's not like that. I am actually coming out with solutions as I'm journaling as well. So it has happened with me a lot of times that as I'm journaling, I have come up with ideas, I have come up with solutions to my issues, and I've come out with a different perspective on things that are going on in my life. So journaling, you can also try that out. You can try out meditation, you can try out yoga, you can do all of those things. But always make sure that these things are readily available for you. Okay, so now you must be thinking that Vani, you are talking about having an outlet, but how do you actually get an outlet, right? So you only need to keep two things in mind, okay? Number one is it needs to feel like a safe place for you, okay? It does not need to feel like you're feeling judgmental, or you should not have second thoughts about that particular thing. So for example, journaling is a safe place for me. You know, if I journal, I feel safe. My journal is in a safe place, so nobody's gonna check my journal, you know. So that is a safe place for me. For you, going to the gym could be a safe place because, you know, nobody's gonna come up to you there and tell you why are you gymming because you're angry or anything like that. Nobody's gonna judge you there. You are there for the reason that everybody is there, you know, so nobody's gonna judge you there as well. So all of these things tend to be a safe place, you know. It needs to feel very safe to talk to, okay? It could be a friend, as I said before. So choose that kind of a friend who does not exactly burden you with a lot of questions, or does not exactly judge you when you tell them how you feel, or does not react in a negative way. So you need to find that person or that particular thing that actually feels safe to talk to. And the second thing that you need to do is that it needs to make you happy, okay? It needs to make you happy no matter what. And it also needs to take that weight off of your shoulders. Now, trust me guys, when I'm sad, I journal. When I'm happy, I journal. When I feel angry, I journal, okay? When I journal, I feel like a very big weight has lifted off of my shoulders. And I don't need to carry these emotions with me all day round. You know, so I just have that one journal, I write in that journal, and everything is back to normal in my life, okay? So always have such a thing that you can, you know, always go to and is readily available, makes you happy no matter what, and also feels safe to talk to. So I think this is it for today, guys. I have no idea how short this video is going to be because trust me, it's not even like less than 15 minutes I recorded this video. Anyways, so I'll see you in the next video, guys. My name is Vani Tuggal, aka The Spiritual She-Wolf. Hit me up on Instagram if you want to talk to anyone. I'm always here to help, okay? And even if you just want to become friends, hit me up on Instagram. I will see you in the next video, guys. This is Vani Tuggal, aka The Spiritual She-Wolf, signing off. Bye! So the number one kind of... Outlet. To the person who has substance... Why did I say let's go? Hi guys, my name is Vani Tuggal, aka The Spiritual She-Wolf. Did I say that right? Now that that's out of the way, so that's out of the way.